So today we're speedrunning through Kindergarten 2, which is going to be much more violent than you might think. Now we'll start our speedrun as soon as we go through this door, and right away we want to go and talk to the two rich kids, Ted and Felix. Basically, they have a plan where they're going to try to kill Ozzy, and I'm going to help them with that now. So first of all, what I need to do is come over to Monty, and we're going to buy a battery. That's going to be useful later, and for now I have to go over to Cindy, and basically we're going to need her help. But to get her to help us, we have to stick some gum into this other girl, Carla's hair. So she's going to get upset, but Cindy will agree to help us later. And for one last thing, I'm going to go down to Carla and kind of make up with her because we're gonna need her help later. But now it's class time, and right away we're gonna go right over to Ozzy. We're gonna give him the battery that we bought earlier so he'll move away from his cubby. Also, Nugget comes in and don't really mind all the blood spewing from him. That'll be important later. For now, I'm gonna talk to Ted. He basically tells me his entire plan of killing Ozzy. You know, it's gonna be a great time. So we need a distraction, and because of that, we can talk to Cindy, and yeah, now they're going to have a domestic dispute. Yeah, this game is interesting. But after that, we're gonna take the inhaler and some illegal drugs from the cubbies, which we're going to be able to use later. But it is now lunchtime, and right away, Ted's gonna come right to us, and he shares some more details about his plan. Now we have to go out to the hallway, but before we can do that, we have to buy a hamburger, so we do that right there. Then after that, we can go into the hallways, but to go upstairs, we have to use these drugs that we got earlier, we give them to him, and we'll be going upstairs later. But for right now, the plan is going to be stressing out Ozzy. So what we're gonna do at this point is we sit in his favorite toilet, and yeah, I guess he's really upset because of that. Then after that, we'll leave, and we'll just go upstairs. Because one last thing we have to do during this time is buy some scissors, which we're gonna use later. Now Ozzy comes up to us, and he's like, hey, where's my inhaler? But we tell him we don't know where it is and then proceed to sell it. And then we go up to this gate and get this flower, which we're gonna use later to kill him. So we tell Ted that we got the flower, all that kind of stuff, but we're gonna need Carla's help to do the rest of this. So Carla's pretty upset at Ted still, but she does tell us that she will help us. But to help us, we kinda have to break Monty's wheelchair. Yeah, it happens. But she tells us that she'll open Ozzy's locker for us and we'll be using that later. Now we need another distraction so we can actually go out to the hall. So what I'm going to do is go over to this power outlet and then come back to Cindy, where we're gonna tell her we'll give her a flower if she sticks a fork in it. Yeah, you can probably see where this is heading. Anyway, the power is now out, so we can go to the hallway and take the inhaler from the orange locker. At this point, we need to go back to Cindy and take the flower, because of course that's going to be the perfect thing to kill Ozzy. Now Ozzy is like, oh, go get my inhaler, but too bad for him, it's not there anymore. And that's going to be our first ending completed. So yeah, pretty good day overall. Of course, after the day, we can then go talk to Ted and Felix, and they're going to give me a prestigious pin. That basically tells them that I'm friends of their company, and they'll be helping me later. But now it's time for the next ending, which is going to be the janitor ending. So right away, I want to go and talk to the janitor, and he says, oh, who is this new janitor? And then we learn that the new janitor's name is Bob. So we go back to the original janitor, and he basically tells us that he has a declaration of war. So then we go back and deliver that to Bob, but he's gonna read it later. So finally, we can finish out this day by going back to the janitor, and yeah, you can probably guess this is going to be a violent day. So right at the beginning of class time, we're gonna go out to the hallway, because it's time to talk to the janitor. Also, hi Nugget. So we'll talk to him, and he's basically like, yeah, I gotta kill the other janitor. This is war. So he's going to need our help, but to go up the stairs to meet the other janitor, he has to get an elevator pass. So we try to go up there, but we get stopped by the hall monitor, and because of that, yeah, this happens. He also just doesn't stop. This game is great. Anyway, we can now go freely to literally anywhere we want. So first of all, we go to the girls' bathroom and we go over to Bob, and he's going to try to work it out with the other janitor. He thinks he's able to, but yeah, you can probably already guess what's going to happen. But anyway, after that, we're going to the science classroom and we tell Monty that we need his elevator key. And then finally, we go back to the janitor, give him the elevator key, and it's time for him to go to war. Also, this happens where the dead kid basically tells me I need to go to lunch. Yeah, this game is so morbid. But the janitor wants us to leave at this point. So we're gonna talk to Carla and tell her that we need a distraction, and that's going to allow us to leave. The other hall monitor just lets us go by because he does not want that happening to him. Oh, and yeah, also this is happening. So the janitor kind of took out the other janitor, and Miss Applebottom is very smart and just leaves. probably the best idea you've ever had. But we have to help him out because there are too many body parts. So we're going into the janitor's closet and we're going to be picking up a chainsaw. And yes, we're doing exactly what you think we're gonna do with this chainsaw. Whoever said this game was violent? It's not at all. But there we go, we also get his head for some reason, but we're now in detention, so we have to say nothing to make sure the guy doesn't shoot us, and that he's going to leave class. Because I guess he doesn't really care about detention. But the janitor wants our help again, because Penny is going to try to take him out. So what we have to do is we have to take a toy car, and we're going to set it on the staircase. Then we'll go over to the garbage can, and we're gonna put the head there. After that, Penny comes by, and she's like, why aren't you in detention? So we tell her that we're looking for the janitor, tell her where he is, and yeah, I guess Penny's dead now. And when we come back, yeah, there's some very interesting green liquid, but we don't have time to worry about that because we have to come back to the classroom and show Dr. Janitor that we didn't move at all. Now it's time to go to gym. But the janitor, of course, needs our help one more time, so we're gonna have to get out of gym class. Now what we can do is we can help Carla take the ball and then blame Jerome. And the teacher gets very upset and runs after him. And with that, we can now leave gym class. We have a couple more things to set up. First of all, we have to go back to the janitor's closet and we're going to pick up the head. And then after that, we also wanna get some of the goo that we saw earlier. Don't worry, it's important later. So at this point, we're going all the way through this yard and we're going to see the garbage can and our janitor who, for some reason, really doesn't want to wipe off that blood. But we have to bang on the dumpster and we see that there's someone in the dumpster and she's saying we can't throw the head in unless we give her some of the goo. Yeah, it all works out. This game. You know, no matter how many times I speedrun it, I'm never gonna get used to it. Anyways, the janitor is going to meet us at the end of the day, and he decides to give us Bob's tool belt, which, like everything else, will come in useful later. Now time for another Tuesday, and this time we're going to do the scientist ending. So first of all, we have to go to Monty and tell him we need to use the handicap ramp. He tells us for $3 we can, and yeah, I guess it'll work. Then we go over here, and we talk to Nugget, who is trapped in a sewer grate. So we tell the principal, and she gets her sister to go over and keep him company. After that, we'll talk to Dr. Danitor. He says we're below average, so we have to prove him wrong. To complete this ending, we have to find 5 different flowers, and the first one is going to be right here, which is why we need the handicap ramp. Then after that, we can go upstairs and see the two hall monitors talking to each other. Now, the original hall monitor doesn't really like the new guy, so he's basically like, hey, thanks for doing that, I guess, and gives me a hall pass. But now what we're going to do is first we have to talk to Cindy and ask for a flower. She tells us that she can give us a flower if we deliver a love letter to Felix. So we go out there, we use the pass, and just go through the hallways. And then after that, we're also going into the girls' bathroom where we see Bob, and we basically tell him that he should try to date Miss Applegate and get her flowers. So now it's lunchtime, and Felix is like, wow, Cindy is quite a handful, and she wants vegan food. So first of all, what we're gonna do is we talk to Carla, and we need a distraction from her. So she's gonna talk to Stevie and basically make him go outside. After that, we can talk to the lunch lady and get some vegan food from her. So she's gonna have to go prepare that, and while she's doing that, we can go into the teacher's lounge. We see Dr. Danitor over here, so we show him one of our flowers, and we can get the second one, which is going to be this yellow one. Then finally, we can go take our vegan food and deliver it to Felix nice and easy. Now at recess time, Felix tries talking to us again, and basically we need to do another thing where we're going to have to drop this beehive on Penny. So we shake the tree, and yeah, I'm so sorry, Penny. But you know, we did everything we need to do, and Cindy is very happy, so she finally decides to give us the flower. It took so long. Also, Bob comes by and he's basically like, here are these flowers, and they decide they're in love with each other, I guess. So I got another flower. Finally, we're gonna talk to Monty and we're going to sell him the drugs so we'll have enough money for science class. And we can also pick up this green flower, and there we go, that's our 5 flowers. Now in science class, we tell Dr. Danitor that we got all the flowers. So he comes and gives us a plant. Now we have to feed the plant the flowers in the order that we got them. So it's going to be blue, yellow, purple, red, and then green. And Dr. Danitor is like, wow, you actually did it. So he gives us an A+, which we're going to be able to use to go to the smart kids class at the beginning of every morning. So yeah, another thing we'll be using for later. And we actually use this one right away because it's time for the kill Penny ending. We're gonna take the A+ and Bob's tool belt and then go off to school. Right away, we wanna talk to Carla and tell her that we can smuggle stuff in. So we take that challenge, but then we talk to Penny and she takes it. So we can talk to Bugs, who is going to be like, oh, oh, she took your stuff too? And I'm like, yeah. So we decide we need to get back at her. I tell her that we can still be friends, even though that is very much a lie. And then we talk to the principal, and she gives us a principal pass so we can talk to her during lunchtime. Now we're in the smart kids class, and right away we want to talk to Penny, who basically tells us about a doll. Then we're going to go over here and take an assessment and take the spray bottle, because for some reason, after you take the assessment, you get a prize, which is cleaning material. It's very interesting. Anyways, we have to go down and get the dolly that Penny was talking about earlier. But Cindy is using it, and of course she wants to play house and fight over custody, but I just spray her in the face. And yeah, we have the doll now. So we can go over to Penny and show her the doll, and she's gonna hide it under her desk. And finally, we can switch the assignment over to magnetics, so that's what science class is going to be later. At this point, it's time for lunch, and we come up with a plan with Bugs. Basically, I'm going to the principal's office, and he's going to start a food fight. So as soon as I come in, the principal has to leave. Now we got a disc earlier, which we can insert that in her computer and take the document. Then we're gonna go over to this door and unlock it, which will also be useful. After this, we wanna show Bugs that document and he's going to get Monty to read it. And after that, it's recess time, but we can just skip through that and it's time to go to science class. Now once we make it into class, we notice that a gear that we need for the magnet isn't there. So we have to go and find it, which is when we see Bugs and Carla. Now they need some time to get the gear out of the locker, so we have to distract Penny. So what we're gonna do is take the doll we had earlier and give it to Penny so she doesn't focus on the gear too much. After that, enough time has passed to where we can get the gear back from Carla, and it's time for another death in this beautiful game. So we give the gear to Dr. Janitor, and yeah, that happens. By the way, Penny's a robot. I feel like that was kind of obvious, but now it's very obvious. Oh yeah, Dr. Janitor also flies away. You know, he doesn't really want to get in trouble. So our fourth ending is now done, and we can talk to Bugs at the end of the day, and he's going to give us Penny's laser beam. But finally, we have what you've all been waiting for, and we're doing the nugget ending. For this, we need the tool belt and the prestigious pin. So right when we get into school, we're going to want to buy a lighter. That'll be useful later. Then after that, we can talk to Nugget, and he's going to ask us to get help, so we can talk to Bob and give him his tool belt so he can help Nugget. Nugget is now free, and it's time to befriend him. But Nugget can't just trust us right away. He needs us to get him a flower. So we tell Bob to move out of the way, because apparently Nugget's handicap. I don't really know what goes on with this part, but we get that blue flower and Nugget now trusts us. Now after this, we can talk to Nugget again and we need a lighter, which we already have, and we're gonna get Carla to smuggle it in. You'll see why this is useful just in a little bit, but there we go, a little bit more money we spent. And it's time to befriend Nugget a little bit more. We're gonna talk to him and he's going to tell us that he needs to find a shovel and we need to leave to do that. So he tells our teacher that there are pills outside. Yeah, by the way, if you miss kindergarten one, she is addicted to pills. So we use that to our advantage and then go over to the janitor's closet where the janitor tells us that he doesn't have the key. So we have to go all the way up the stairs and also tell this hall monitor that he can just take the lighter in the locker and that's what lets us go through. Then Bob already knows we need the key so we can take that and go back downstairs. Now finally we go back to the janitor, give him the key and get a shovel. It's now lunchtime but Nugget notices that they're selling burgers instead of nuggets for lunch. Obviously this makes Nugget mad. So we talk to him, he tells us his grievances and we need to buy all the burgers. Now what we can do is we can use the prestigious pin to make one of these brothers buy a burger and then he's just going to give it to us. And then after that we're going to buy the other burger, which means that the lunch lady is going to have to make some more. So while she's doing that we can go right over here and take the chicken nuggets. Now we show these chicken nuggets to Nugget but he notices they're cold and starts banging his head in the wall. But we tell him, hey, we can just microwave it. So yeah, we go to the teacher's lounge and we microwave it. I know, amazing. After this, we see that Nugget is definitely okay. And show him the nuggets and everything's fine. But as soon as we make it to recess, Miss Applebottom is very upset at Nugget because he lied about the pills. So to calm her down, we have to go over to the teacher's lounge and buy her a soda. Yeah, it's actually really easy to get her not to kill Nugget. Who would have guessed that just a soda would have done it? Hooray. But at this point, everything is prepared and it's time to make the new Nugget Cave, which Nugget is really good at making them. So we can drop all the nuggets down into Nugget Cave. And yeah, there we go, we're good friends. Now, right as we make it into Nugget Cave, we notice there's a leg, so we take it. And then all we have to do is wait a little bit more and then go to gym class because our last mission is going to be winning dodgeball with Nugget. So it's going to be literally everybody in the class versus me and Nugget. Right away, I can use the leg and that takes out Carla. Then after that, I have to move up and Nugget is going to hit both of the brothers. I can move back, throw that ball at Jerome. And finally, all we have to do is take care of Bugs. So I'm gonna move down and then he's going to throw that hit Nugget, but I catch it, so we beat him. And there we go, we're Nugget's best friend now. So at this point, because we completed another ending, we're gonna get some more stuff. Nugget tells us that Lily is in the school and gives us a Monster Mon plushie, which is going to be important later. How many times have I said that sentence? Anyways, it's time for the Felix ending, where we're going to kill Felix's brother, Ted. So we need the prestigious pin and the A+. Right away, we're going to Felix and we're going to show him the pin so he's like, oh, you're actually important. So we start talking to him and then we buy some hand sanitizer and try to show a note to Ozzy, but he needs the hand sanitizer to touch it. And then finally we go over here and we get Monty to read it, but he won't because he saw us talking to a rich kid. So we have to get that money from him and we can go back to Monty. Now he's going to read it for us. Now we're gonna go to the smart kid class and right away we'll talk to Felix where he lets us know that instead of killing Ozzy, he's actually trying to kill his brother because he wants to be the sole heir. So we're gonna help him with that after we take our assessment and we get some toilet paper. See, we need to get the spiders that are on one of the top shelves. And to do that, first of all, we need to clog this toilet and then tell Bob that the toilet is clogged. So he's gonna go away and we can go on this vent that he was cleaning earlier and take the spiders. After that, we can go over to Felix and show him the spiders, which he's going to give us a burger, which will be useful. Then we can go to Nugget and tell him that we need him to dig another Nugget cave, which we tell him if he does it, Felix will take him to a Nugget factory. But he tells us he needs both a shovel and a new arm. So first of all, we need to get the shovel, so we get a janitor key from Carla. So we got the janitor's key, we can use the burger to go out, and we're going to the janitor's closet. Now, once we make it in here, of course, we're just gonna take a shovel. You know, it's kind of normal stuff. Also, Bob is like, why are you here? But we don't have time to worry about that because before anything else, we have to go up to the dumpster. Now we're going to bang on the dumpster and we're going to give the dumpster lady a burger so that she gives us another hall pass. Now we have to get the arm, so we're gonna take it from Monty. But the thing is, Monty was prepared for that and has a gigantic gun, but he accidentally shoots the hall monitor. But hey, look, we have an arm, so I guess it doesn't really matter. It's now time for gym class though, and it's also time for the final parts of our plan. Right away, we send out Ted, but we also have to leave, so we're gonna have to do the thing again where we help Carla grab the ball, and then the teacher gets really mad at Jerome. Oh yeah, also we're about to get to see whatever happened with that, but just wait for a second. We're also gonna give the arm to Nugget and he's going to be able to start digging. Finally, we can talk to Felix, we both leave, but before we do anything else, we have to go into the classroom and anyway, I'm just gonna take this stick. See you later. So it's finally time to push Ted into Nugget Cave. Also, Stevie's still there. Hey, dude. But we can go over there. We give him the stick and he's going to push his brother right in there. And yeah, he fell for a while, it seems like. And then after that, we're going to take the spiders and then drop them in the hole just because I don't really know. Poor guy, that's probably awful. But hey, it doesn't really matter to us because we completed another mission. And with this, we're also gonna get some strange chemicals, which we can use later to make pills. But we'll talk about that in a bit. Oh yeah, also Nugget goes off with Felix, so they can go to the Nugget factory. I don't really know what they do with that. But at this point, it's time to do the Carla ending. So we need the Monster Mom plush, the A+, and the laser. Now, right away, we show Carla the laser and she tells us that we can help her. After this, what we have to do is we talk to Cindy. She says that we're no longer her boyfriend and gives us a tissue, which we can use with Jerome. Now we go back to Carla and we tell her about Jerome. And basically, Jerome wants to find Lily because he thinks that Lily killed his father. You know, if you remembered what happened in the previous game, it makes sense. So Lily goes and distracts Bob while I get Nugget out of the sewer grate. After this, we can go over and talk to Carla and she tells us that we need to go beneath the sewer grate. So first of all, we need to take the assessment, and I'm also going to take the toilet paper. Then it's time to go to the hallway and continue our mission. So we can go through here, but of course, Stevie's going to try to stop us, but he only stops Carla because my bathroom is down here. So then I go down here and unlock the door, and it's time to finally see what Nugget was doing down here. So we can squeak this plushie right by this box, and we see that Lily and Billy are here. So we tell Lily that Jerome is after her, and she's like, oh, I have to clear up this misunderstanding. For some reason. But yeah, that's pretty much all we have to do. At this point, we just talk to Jerome, tell him that he needs to meet Lily during lunch, and it's time to get started on that plan. Now, before anything else, we do need a distraction. So what we're gonna do is we're going to buy a burger. Then we can give that burger to Bugs, and he's going to start a food fight. You know, this is always just a fun time. Poor Nugget. And also, I guess, Ozzy as well. So yeah, they start fighting back, and Nugget, of course, uses a nugget for his. I don't even know where he got those. But the room is now sufficiently distracted, so we can leave. Now we're gonna go upstairs into the girls' bathroom. Then if we knock on the right stall, we'll see that Lily is there. Now Jerome tries to kill Lily, but we clear up the misunderstanding, and I guess we're all friends now. But Lily tries to leave and see that Penny is by the stairs, so we have to do some quick thinking and go through the vent. Then we're pretty much home free. All I have to do is go over to the lesson plan, and we're going to change it to robotics. But because we snuck in this class, we're gonna have to go to detention. Now with here, pretty much everybody is in detention, and he decides to sleep. Now after this, we need to get the device that Jerome was holding. But the thing is, the janitor moved it, so we have to do some jobs for him to get it. Now he tells us basically that we have to go through and stock up the toilet paper and also the spray bottles. So since we got separate things earlier in the day when we did our lesson plans, we're just able to go and do that. So we meet back up and then go over to the girls' bathroom. But this time the janitor tells us that he doesn't even have it. It's actually in the janitor's closet. So we have to go all the way back down and through this building. And we also see that this room is, yeah, I don't really know what's going on here, but we don't have to worry about it right now. We got our device and all we have to do is make it back to detention before Mr. Janitor wakes up. So we can pass time right there. He's going to wake up and it's time to go to science. Now during science, we have to break the device that Jerome had. So we ask Monty to help us with that. And he tells us we need to give him $20 or make Carla his girlfriend. So Carla reluctantly agrees and we can finally place this device and then push the button. That's going to crush it and get everything that Carla wanted. So there we go. That's going to be the Carla ending. And she's also going to give us a laser bomb. See, I didn't say it this time. But it's time for the Miss Applebottom ending where we need the Monster Mon plush and the strange chemicals. So first of all, what we want to do is talk to Carla and we're going to do the whole smuggle thing so we get a firecracker. After this, we talk to Miss Applebottom and she's very close to snapping. So we get in a fight with Cindy. And then as soon as she tries to fight, she then starts beating Cindy because she is not having a very good day. So Bugs is really impressed by us because we almost made the teacher snap. But before anything else, we also need Monty's help because we do have to smuggle in this firecracker. We can just go in the side of the building and it's nice and easy. So we're gonna put the firecracker in our cubby and our teacher for some reason just doesn't really care that we were there before. And we can go all the way up to the cubby and pop the firecracker, which as you guess, yeah, our teacher is not having the greatest day in the world. So she starts yelling about how she hates children and stuff, you know, just kind of normal teacher things. And it is now time for us to go help her. What we're gonna do is we're going to make new pills for her so she won't be so upset. Now to do this, we're going to need Monty's help because he's a super genius. So we're gonna go up to the science class and we're going to show him the strange chemicals. So he's gonna be like, wow, that's actually what I need. But what he also needs is DNA from three different students who have taken the pills before. So that's going to be our job for today. We get some scissors so we can use that for that purpose. And we tell Miss Applebottom about what we have to do. So she basically goes and tells Nugget that she needs a lock of his hair, but he does not want to give it to her. Yeah, we're gonna see how that works out later. For now though, Monty starts talking to us and he tells us that Billy should be downstairs, so we should take a piece of his hair. Now, of course, we go over to Carla. We also show her the firecracker because that was a mission earlier, and we're going to be getting her help too. So then we buy the burger, we go back down, and we have the elevator key, so we can now go down here and squeak this next to the box. Now we're going to see Billy and Lily, but this time we're not trying to help them. We just want a hair sample. They're not really gonna listen to us though. But anyway, it is now time for recess where our teacher is. She has an interesting look on her face, but we give her the scissors so she's able to cut Nugget's hair. And yeah, this is not the greatest ending for Nugget. But we tell her that Billy won't give us her hair, and she says go back down there and demand it. So that's pretty much just what we do. But the thing is, Billy and Lily are not having the greatest time. Yeah, bye, I'm not really gonna deal with this, am I? Then we can also go into this classroom, and we're gonna take the $3 because we need to make it to science class. But we got all the hair we need, we got the strange chemicals, and we can tell Monty that we got all that. At this point, all we have to do is let Monty make the pills. But other people are gonna wanna use the lab equipment. So Monty gives us some items. He gives us a flower to use on Ozzy, a diamond to use on Cindy, and the doll to use on Penny. So he's then able to finish the pills. All that we have to do is make them red, and that's going to be the pills completed. So that's another mission done. Of course, at the end of the day, our teacher's gonna come over, be like, where are my pills? So we're gonna give it to her, and she's actually really happy. We also get the faculty remote, which you can use to control Penny. So you're probably seeing where this is going, and it's time for the final ending. We're gonna need the Monster Mon plush flush, the faculty remote, and Carla's laser bomb. Now right away, Miss Applebottom says she doesn't have the faculty remote because she kind of just notices that we have it. So we're gonna be able to use that after we get a battery to use Penny to open the grate. So now Nugget is free and we can move forward with our plan. I'm gonna go in here and then right away, I'm going to show Lily and Billy that I actually have the faculty remote. They're going to take it so no one else can take it from me. We're also gonna wanna go over here and talk to the principal so we can get the principal pass. That'll be important later. But now it's time for the fun stuff. And the fun stuff includes killing all the teachers. So we see that Lily or Billy, I'm not sure which one, basically passes us the remote and we're gonna need some help. So first of all, we enlist Bugs. We get the contraband that Penny took from him earlier, which is going to be his knife. Then also we're going to talk to Cindy and enlist her help as well. So we're gonna take back Penny. She's gonna come right over here and we're going to stick some gum in her hair. Then we can just let her go away. And yeah, that was easy. Also, Cindy feels empty because she's upset there is no reaction. But that is going to be our team for killing Miss Applebottom, and it's time to move on to Dr. Janitor. So we need to get into the teacher's lounge. And how we can do that is we can talk to Nugget and we can give him a jackhammer. Because of course, Nugget is going to want his nuggets and then he's also gonna wanna microwave them. So he kinda just does that, takes the nuggets, and now we have a nice hole. We can go through that hole and now we're in the teacher's lounge where Nugget is microwaving his nuggets. We can then place our device. Dr. Janitor is going to make us leave, but he doesn't notice we placed it. And all we have to do now is go to the principal. But before we can start talking to the principal, they hear an explosion. So yeah, she has to leave and we can do whatever we want. Or except these guys came back and don't mind that glitch, that just happens sometimes. But anyways, we're going into the girls' bathroom and we can see that Miss Applebottom has Bugs. So I kind of just go up and stab her. You know, it happens sometimes. It's now recess time. We have the Nugget Cave and we're gonna talk to Penny and use the remote on her, which is going to cause her to freak out and jump down Nugget Cave. Then we can go all the way up to Carla and we can tell her that now that Penny is gone, she can just go into the school. We're also gonna go into the school and to the teacher's lounge where we see this, just don't worry about it. But we need to snap Bob out of it because he needs to go and fight a monster. You know, that monster that we saw earlier. But anyways, before anything else, we need to take the doll because we need to use that for Penny later. And we go back outside and it's time to go to Nugget Cave. Now in here, we can see Penny and we can cheer her up by giving her her doll. At this point, we also see Bob fighting the monster and Penny can actually make it through and allow us to go downstairs where we see a bunch of more kids. So the principal decides to blow up Penny because she doesn't really care about her daughter. I mean, to be fair, her daughter is literally a robot, but it's time to fight some monsters. Now, first of all, I'm gonna protect myself and use the green button to make sure that guy can't kill me. Then secondly, we can use a button on Penny and then we can shoot that monster. And then finally, we're gonna use this blue crane and basically kill that monster. We're all good. But the principal is trying to kill us, so I have to think fast and use the red button, which basically picks her up and then drops her in the green goo. So yeah, there we go. Everything is fine now. Except the principal is now a gigantic monster. Yeah. So anyway, time for another boss fight. First of all, we have to close her mouth. So I'm gonna move the green crane and then close her mouth. And then after that, we're gonna have to expose her eye so I can go and move the red crane. That's going to make it go up. And then Nugget comes down and just completely obliterates her. So yeah, there we go. We killed the principal. Nugget is fine and everything worked out at the end. It's also great because the kids who turned into monsters, I guess, are just kind of okay. I mean, that's pretty cool. And there we go, we finish out the day. We see Bob, you know, he is triumphant over the monster, I guess. Yeah, what a beautiful ending. And we have our little epilogue where we're like, oh yeah, we saved the day. You know, this was such a crazy journey. I don't really care. Please just end off time. I need to finish it now. But yeah, as soon as I stop talking to them and we go off into the sunset, we can end off time. And there we go. 4123. Oh yeah, also you can move around during this scene. That's kind of funny. And if we look on speedrun.com, we'll see that we got sixth place. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.